Why does nothing please you?
Well, this remarkable Jones will definitely be a great addition to the Princeton family. Wait, what's this? A B in AP Lit?
Oh, reject it! There's no room for B's at Princeton!
But I get where you're coming from. Miss Williams was an eyelid teacher 60 years ago.
How can this be?
When she was my teacher, my classmate, John Shea, developed an elixir that gave her immortality.
No!
She'll be torturing children for eternity!
Research paper. What are you doing here?
Excuse me, Splendid Jones. I'm from the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. I need you to follow me, eh?
No!
Pull yourself together. Can't you see your grandmother, Remarkable Jones, was holding her phone when she died?
821-726-4121. Who do you think she was calling?
Stupid girl. It's not a real phone number. Obviously, it's a code.
Well, my grandmother, Remarkable Jones, did say she had a solution to my problem before she died. Do you think she figured out a way to get an A in Miss Williams' class?
That would be incredible. I always thought it was impossible to get an A, but maybe your grandmother, Remarkable Jones, figured out the secret.
But what does the code mean?
821.7? That's the Dewey Decimal number for Samuel Taylor Coleridge.
Oh!
Here it is, the collected works of Samuel Taylor Coleridge. 264 is the page number we're supposed to turn to. Ah, the Rime of the Ancient Mariner.
That was my grandmother, Remarkable Jones's, favorite poem. She used to read it to me all the time when I was younger.
Now, 121 is the line number. Water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink.
At this point in the poem, the sailors are at their most desperate. They're all suffering because of the mariner's decision to kill the albatross.
This part is ironic because the sailors are surrounded by water, but they can't drink any of it because it's salt water. Ironic. Irony. Irony. Iron. Iron! We need to go somewhere made of iron where we're surrounded by water we can't drink.
It can't be that simple. You don't think it means the water fountain, do you?
That's disgusting. That's what I only drink, Fiji water.
Ah, water, water everywhere.
Nor any drop to drink.
Wait, Tom Hanks, look at your spit. It kind of looks like an animal.
I think it might be a bird.
The albatross, the bird from the poem.
The mariner killed the albatross, even though the albatross was a symbol of innocence and purity.
He did feel guilty about killing it, though. He wore it around his neck. Instead of the cross, the albatross around my neck was hung.
The albatross became the mariner's cross to bear.
Wait. Albatross? Cross? Crossing? Railroad crossing? The next clue's at the railroad crossing! Come on!
Let's go!
This rock. It looks just like my grandmother.
Remarkable Jones.
Wow, that's a remarkable resemblance. Splendid Jones, where did you find that rock?
Over there.
Let's start digging.
Tom Hanks, look! I found something.
What is that? I've never seen anything like that before.
It's called a cryptex. My grandmother, Remarkable Jones, used to make them all the time when I was little. In order to open it, you have to guess the secret 5-letter passcode.
But Splendid Jones, we don't have the secret 5-letter passcode, and we don't have any more clues.
We have the only clue we need right here, the rhyme of the ancient mariner.
Well, Samuel Taylor Coleridge was a Romantic poet, and the Romantic movement dealt with the sublime.
They also dealt with the solitary genius, and the mariner could definitely be considered a solitary genius. Wait, solitary, solitaire. Solitaire's a game you play by yourself, and in order to play it, you need playing cards. Cards, that's a secret answer.
Why didn't we think of it sooner? It's so obvious. Quick, enter the password. We've got to get that A.
I'm poet trying! Here's our next clue. To find the place where the secret lies, look to Coleridge's worst poetry.
Coleridge's worst poetry? What do you think that means?
Well, as you know from our extensive discussions in class, Coleridge hated the ending of that poem.
That's right. Many critics felt that the themes were addressed in too blunt of a manner, which was inconsistent with the rest of the poem.
So let's look at those stanzas.
Here it is. Farewell, farewell, but this I tell, to thee, thou wedding geese. He prayeth well who loveth well, both man and bird and beast. He prayeth best who loveth best, all things both great and small. For the dear God who loveth us, he made and loveth all. Well, romantics clearly had a more personal attachment to nature. The albatross could be portrayed as a Christian symbol, but since Coleridge had pantheist leanings, the albatross is probably more symbolic of a natural power.
Of course, the mariner was punished for killing the albatross, a symbolic representation of nature, and his punishment couldn't continue until he learned to respect all parts of nature. Even the water snakes.
So where to next? Let's think. Where can we find both man and bird and beast? Oh, Leta Thompson.
It can't be that simple. Let's go.
Freeze. Stop right there, eh? What's this all about? Hold it. I said stop right there. You're wanted for the murder of Remarkable Jones.
No, I don't take orders from Canadians.
And that gun is obviously fake, and we all know that Miss Williams is the murderess.
Besides, you haven't mattered to the world since 1812.
Half of your country speaks French.
Your country is still technically owned by England.
And the Winter Olympics don't even matter.
Canada's responsible for bringing the world Nickelback. Now get out of our way.
Why does this always happen?
I'm so overwhelmed by the power of nature. It makes me feel insignificant and powerless.
I know that my words give nature power. The more I describe it, the more enthralled I feel and the more power it has. Wait, Tom Hanks. This is it. I can feel it. My grandmother, Remarkable Jones, was definitely here.
Ah, I found it.
Oh, this is it. The secret to getting an A. If an A you seeketh here, be prepared for many tears, because you can't get one.
I want a girl with a mind like a diamond. I want a girl who knows what's best. Attack. She's playing with her jewelry, she's putting up her hair, she's touring the facility and picking up slack. I want a girl with a short skirt and a long jacket.
Action.
No!
Pull yourself together. Can't you see your grandmother, Remarkable Jones, was holding her phone when she died?
821-726-4121. Who do you think she was calling?
Stupid girl. It's not a real phone number. Obviously, it's a code.
Well, my grandmother, Remarkable Jones, did say she had a solution to my calling. I can't look at you and laugh.
Now you, it's like my life. It's too much.